Jesus will appear. Only the foolish ones will say that is no God. And when you say there is no God, you will not believe God.
Yeah.
That is what the Bible says. He said, only the foolish says there is no God.
Wow.
Do you know how they say it? The Bible said they didn't say it with their mouth, they said it in their heart. He said, in their heart they say that there is no God. Then how did they know that they said it when they didn't hear them saying it? Because your character, because your attitude is the expression, is the voice of your heart. You don't need to tell me. The way you behave will tell me what is in your heart.
Stop it.
What's in your heart?
It's your heart.
Some of you are so weak in the spirit to know when somebody is telling you that it is over. Foolishness will make you to lost languages. He said, what with me? When the boy is tired of you, he didn't tell you, baby, I am tired of you. But you are so blind and foolish to know that the time is over. Then you need to clean up yourself and move on with your life. When you are foolish, you sit down, not see the handwriting on the wall, and you cry like a baby. I pray for somebody today that the power and the hand of God will come upon everyone who stands and shouts amen. But I don't know why I'm going this direction. Praise the Lord. So foolishness is a spiritual attack. It's a spiritual attack. Any man or woman you see that is foolish, if you have the mind of God, pray for him. Because it's not his making. If your enemy wants to destroy you totally, not to kill you, just to keep you in long suffering, they attack you with the arrow of foolishness. Because the foolish man will always lose and lost chances. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Chances will be passing you down. If you see some ladies, some girls, whom perhaps we are financially blessed at any age, now they journey into relationship, they have nothing to offer. Since all these years, not because they were not getting money, but they were not able to establish anything because they were foolish. Is it not foolishness that will make you to count $40,000 or even to give a boy for marriage? Is it foolishness?
Foolishness!
Bitter.
Yes,
sir. So, my goodness. After today, may God deliver you from the spirit of foolishness.
Yeah.
I said, after today, may God deliver you from the spirit of foolishness.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
We don't have money to pay rent on the church. And we have members. When you want to give offering, you give one miserable 1 euro or 50 cents. But when they call you that something is wrong with you, that one baba say, if you do this one, do that one, that this will go well with you. You release 300, 400 euro to a native doctor. But when you come to church, you give God 50 cents more. Are you not foolish? Are you not foolish? The pastor that you see that pray for you 101, you don't trust him. The one when they give you number, when you know what they do as the doctor, now you trust. Are you not foolish? May God deliver you from foolishness after today.
Yeah.
I said, may God deliver you from foolishness after today.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Thank you, my Father. He said, don't be afraid of their faces, because this is one of the areas that God is giving deliverance. If you receive this deliverance, your light will shine.
Amen.
Amen. Your light will shine. A wise man is that man that values everything that enters into his hand. Amen. Whatever that enters into your hands is valued. Before you spend it, you think twice. I know that I am not just spending, but I am investing. Listen to me. What will help you to run a sweet financial and marital race is when you come to understand the need to be hired behind serving God. Because if you cannot understand why you come to church, you will not understand why you should prosper in everything you do. And how do I mean? I mean that anytime you come to church and spend time with God, anytime you come to church and spend your money to God, give of whatever thing you spend because of God or in God or of God, you are not just spending, you are investing.
Yes.
Because time spent with God is not time wasted, but time invested. So if you understand investing of time, then you will also understand that there are certain things that you need to understand. understand or invest when you're into a relationship or when you're into finances. So you know that you are not supposed to spend carelessly, but you're supposed to invest wisely. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Invest wisely. Why your mates will run past you is because they are wiser than you. Can I tell you something? Listen to me. One of the things that will make you great in life to fulfill your destiny is what we call secret. So it's a secret. Look, secret is not a sin. Even God itself has a secret. Otherwise, for us, they are finished. Is that? So if we know the secret of God, then we will see a finishing. The devil thought he knew him, that he wanted to assume the same position. He didn't know that God is wiser. God showed him some certain things, but there are one that God did not show him. That is what makes him a God. Our God is not foolish. He's a wise God. That is why you also should be wise. Praise the Lord. Secret is one of the key, vital key, that will take you far in life. Listen, the day you know what I'm doing, and begin to do what I'm doing, you will become like me. I don't need to respond to that.
Yes, sir.
The day you know what I am doing to prosper, and then you start doing it, you become like me. But if you don't know it, you can never be like me. Men that go far in life are men that keep secret. Why people can enter your marriage and break it is because you talk too much. Now my best friend, we don't get to know the three each other.
Yeah.
We didn't get to know each other something. That is why you do trust him. The day you have a problem with him, that secret you told him or her is what she used against you. So when you don't have secrets, you are a foolish person.
Mm-hmm.
So secret is one of the keys that will make you to prosper in life.
Mm.
And when God wants to give you blessing, he gives it to you secretly.
Mm.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And when it is given to you secretly, then you testify publicly.
Okay.
God called Abraham 1:1 and then blessed him.
Mm-hmm.
He could have said it in public, but it was a personal thing within Abraham and God. So when God wants to promote you, they come to you 1:1, and he release some keys, some hidden mysteries about what you are looking for. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As you hear my voice today, may your heart be open.
Amen.
May your ear be open.
Amen.
May your head be anointed.
Yeah.
To receive from God.
Yeah.
The hidden mysteries about your success in life.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say secret.
Secret.
Say secret.
Secret.
Amen. We are talking about living a life of gratitude. Yeah. Amen. Because every man that carries gratitude will not die destitute.
Amen.
I did hear amen from somebody.
Amen.
Everyone that